doesn't have any mob essence, so maybe it's not working?
It needs energy.
Oh, okay.
You'll see that it has three things when you...
Oh, yeah.
On the lightning bolt. Top is Minecraft jewels. Second is energy units. And the third is kilojoules from universal electricity.
Okay. Is it going to need a chest to pop Ludo into?
It'll pop out into the world.
Okay.
But this thing has to be on that side. The sheep has to be on the other side.
Okay.
We're going to have to push them into position.
Do you have that bone? I'll quickly grow some wheat.
Hold on a second. Almost got it. I don't got it.
Give me the bone.
Yeah, here's two of them, actually.
Awesome.
Okay, it's going to take a while to charge up. I knew this was going to happen. But on the plus side, if we happen to be around here in the future... Oh, really, sheep? Really?
Yep, really.
All right. I bow to the law of numbers.
They don't seem to be paying any attention to me. Oh, here we go.
Here we go. It killed this one here, and then it popped out the wool behind it. Do you see it?
Yeah, I see it.
Yep. Well, that's what it does to everything in front of it. And there's just a little bit of essence. We'll have to kill 10 things before we can offload it into a tank.
Come here. Come here, you idiots.
Fill a bucket full of it.
Come on. Why are you not paying attention to me?
If you see any, whoa, lag.
Yeah.
If you should happen to see any, is there enough energy left to run it?
You okay?
This thing's been bothering me all day, and I don't know if it's just allergies or dust or what.
Okay.
This thing will only activate when there's something in front of it that it can kill. And it's got a useful radius of about 5x5.
Got another one.
So basically, we can put these right next to the door on each entrance and never have to worry about creepers ambushing us again.
Nice.
But we will have to get the materials to make them. Books are not an issue. Tin gears are not an issue. Gold is just scarce. It's not it's not super critical right now.
Mm-hmm.
Gold swords, I think, would be more efficient if we were just to set this thing up in the Nether and just have a whole bunch of pigmen die, because I don't think they freak out the way they would if we killed some pigmen.
Yeah.
So basically, it would be like the thing in... well, I can't say that because some people probably haven't seen it, so it'd be spoilers. But... Okay, come on. Wait for it.
Fire the laser! It should be a laser.
It's got enough... It's got more than enough power. And in fact, it has killed twice. There's... Because it generates 100 mil buckets for each kill.
There we go.
And it outputs some wool here. So once all the power is gone into this thing, it's good for 7 more shots, then we can move it.
Okay.
In the meantime, since it's going to be night, let's try and lure some zombies in front of it.
Here. Does it have to be directly in front of it?
In a 5x5 level on its... Try and mark it out.
Oh, I see. No.
I don't have any torches. I should have some torches, but I do not.
That's okay.
So, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So anything in this area will eventually. I mean, it won't instantly die by walking into it.
Okay.
But if we lure it past enough times, there should be a creeper. This will kill it, and it'll give us... it'll give us its gunpowder.
Okay. Can buildcraft pipes and chests interact with this thing?
A chest can. Chest would have to be right next to it.
Okay.
And we'd want the, well, I don't have any liquid ducts with me either, but it has an internal tank. We can worry about that later.
Okay.
Now, as a matter of fact...
Excuse me.
If I were to remove this torch and we were just to head back and end the night, something might spawn in here during that time, get itself killed, and... Well, we wouldn't do that. Do we? Do you have any chests on you, or wood?
I just put a chest right behind it.
Okay. I think that'll help.
Okay. How much power does it need? Is it gonna fill?
Yeah.
Okay.
I thought I heard something moving in the grass, so...
Oh, okay. I'm going to drop another charcoal in the Sterling Engine to keep it going.
No, don't do that.
Why?
Do that.
Too late.
It can only... Oh, shit.
Why? What?
This thing can only accept so much power.
Okay. It's not going to fill up.
Well, actually, based on the calculations I saw, two charcoal will fill it all the way up, but we didn't want it all the way up.
Why?
Because we wanted to move it and have it near our entrances.
Okay.
So that we could have it a defensive move. But now we'll have to wait until it's depleted before we can get anything out of it.
It'll be fine.
Yeah. Look, it will be fine. It's just going to take forever is all. Wait.
It's kind of a test run anyway.
Yeah.
What's up, jerk? You want to follow me to my toy? Come on.
Now keep in mind that you've walled off two sides.
Yes.
You will not be able to escape.
That's fine.
Which is going to be an issue if there turns out to be a creeper.
It's all good.
You know, I just realized I recognize this sensation in my sinus cavity.
What's that?
It's the same one I had that one time when I was getting sick on the tractor.
Oh, yeah?
So, I think I'm getting sick.
Ah.
Yeah, there we go. Unfortunately, any place you can go, he can go.
There.
Up there. This
And we've got rotten flesh in the chest.
There's a rotten flesh in the chest.
We got experience for it that time, though, because I smacked him once.
Actually, we can see how many things it's killed.
Oh, really?
Not numerically. We can work backwards.
Oh, with the click on loot.
With the essence.
Oh, okay.
Every time it kills something, essence goes up by 100.
Okay, so it's killed 4 critters.
Yep. But anyway, once we're done with the trial run, I want to set that up in the Nether. And just get us a whole bunch of Pigman Golden Swords. In the meantime, I'm going to build a sewer to collect waste from these sheep that we do have and do want.
Okay.
And I'll probably just put a composter right next to it. What?
Oh, nothing. Don't mind me. I'm just playing with my new toy.
You're enjoying this way too much.
Yep.
Just saying. You are.
Oh, crap.
Okay, let's see how much power is left in this system.
So, it's killed 6 mobs. I lured a couple skeletons to it. I figured the skeletons would be the easiest. Here. Come here, spider.
the thing I was talking about earlier, the way things interact with each other as far as mods go.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry.
No problem.
By the time I get my thoughts arranged enough to voice, to communicate, my voice decides, nope.
Okay.
For now that Mind Factory uses thermal expansion base blocks instead of factory blocks, this makes some stuff slightly more expensive.
Okay.
But that's not an issue because at the same time, thermal expansion makes it possible to get twice as much as you normally would.
Okay.
And Mind Factory, as far as I know, doesn't include that possibility. What this means for, there's a skeleton I'm trying to lure in there.
It's fine.
Here's a zombie that's coming from another direction. There we go.
It may not have enough power for another kill.
Okay, I'm looking at an Enderman. Yeah, I'm here.
Look
I dare
away
you.
From him. Here we go.
I just did.
Dude, you are gonna get killed.
I guess it doesn't have enough power.
I just said that. I hear the Enderman. Be careful.
Yeah. Well, once he went for a dip, he kind of lost interest.
That zombie didn't have a face for a minute. That was kind of scary. Okay. So how much power does it need per kill?
I forget specifically, but it's several hundred, I think.
Okay. Before I look at this Enderman.
Yeah, we gotta make sure that there's enough
There's
power.
A creeper over there, be careful.
Yeah, there's a creeper behind you, too.
Is there?
Behind the wall. Oh. It's over on the other side, though, so we're okay.
Ha!
For now.
The Enderman put his block of sand
And now
down.
It sees me. Yeah. But what I was talking about was that thermal expansion, what we lose in recipe cheapness for Mind Factory, we get back from bonus resources.
Okay.
And, like, the modular power suits mod has a whole bunch of recipes designed to work with a whole bunch of different mods. Like, there's some very cheap stuff. Here we go.
Come at me, buddy. Come at me, bro.
There we go. There's some very cheap stuff. Yep, we got a confirmed Ender Pearl.
Nice. Confirmed kill.
Yep. But, like, some recipes are very cheap because they use vanilla stuff, and then there's slightly more expensive stuff for a whole bunch of different mods.
Mm-hmm.
And depending on which mod you have that's central, if you do have one that's central, like thermal expansion seems to be for us here, then you tend to get a balanced thing where early on stuff is easy to get, but the later, more advanced stuff, you get in what you get out. You get out what you put in, I should say.
Okay. The Sterling engine has stopped.
Yeah. Okay.
It's probably got enough energy for at least one more kill.
Yeah, there should be. And then we will...
Here, I'm gonna go piss off a spider.
Okay. And then we will pipe out the essence into a bucket. And in fact, I got an idea. I'll be right back.
Okay.
Go to hell and tell the devil I'm coming for him next.
Okay, so is there a specific side where the waterproof pipes, or the liquid ducts, attach to pipe out the essence?
First, I need to make some tools.
Okay. Man, I need more inventory space. Here.
I'm gonna have to cook up this, this rubber. And there's no power in the engine, of course. Here we go.
Oh, you jerk. Trying to lure the creeper into the water so it wouldn't break anything? I smacked him once and he landed on land and then exploded.
Yep. That happens.
So what's the block that you, that shears the sheep, what's it called?
Okay, I'm trying to think from memory, and I'm a little bit distracted right now.
Sorry.
Now, you have a valid question, I just can't seem to get the information to form in my head. Let's see. Okay. Grinder has one input for power, it's on one side. We put the other side... chest. The block on the other side that isn't the, like the smashy teeth animation, puts two liquiducts down there.
Okay.
One next to it and one next to the original liquiduct. But wait. Don't hook up the liquiduct to the block yet. I just realized something.
Okay. I'm not even over there. I've got to put some stuff in a chest. And I looked it up. It's a rancher.
Yeah, that's it. Well, that and the sewer.
We'll need both?
The sewer will help us later on, but here's a little... There's a secondary tool that doesn't see a lot of use, as far as I know. At least you wouldn't think it's that useful. Okay. Do you have any liquiducts on your person?
I have four, yes.
Okay.
And a portable tank.
We won't need the portable tank, we just need a glass tank.
Okay. Why? Sure. Won't we want to move it?
We're going to empty it immediately.
Okay.
Because that's not going to be our permanent setup for it.
Okay.
This is just to show what it's capable of. And you have a crafting table over there, right?
Yeah, I left one out there.
Okay. I got 8 glass.
Okay. I have a tank with me, actually. I have a portable tank and a regular tank.
Okay. What we have to do with this kind of stuff, because it doesn't always know what it should hook up to first.
Mm-hmm.
Look at all this free dirt.
Yeah. There we go.
Close enough.
Yep.
Order of operations doesn't matter. Toss me 2 liquiducts, please.
Okay.
There we go.
Okay.
And do you have a bucket?
No.
You're going to need a bucket. Hold on a second.
Okay.
Have a bucket.
Okay.
And now have a straw.
Okay. What? What?
Use the bucket on this thing, and you'll get a bucket of mob essence.
Why? I'm not going to drink this, am I?
It'll give you an experience level. You're absorbing the power of your enemies.
Are you serious?
I am quite serious, although I'm not sure how it works specifically.
This is fucking gross.
Well, yeah, I can do it. I could use another level. I'm planning to go through a whole bunch of enchantments later, once we build an enchanting table.
I don't know how to make this work.
Okay, try putting the... Oh, I got an idea.
Okay.
Try pouring the bucket in there.
So I'm going to drink mob essence from the dirt ground.
No, you're not going to drink it. You're not going to drink it. You're going to do this.
Oh.
Go ahead. It gives you night vision for 60 seconds.
Whoa!
In the sky. It's brighter. You should see this at night.
That's awesome.
Night vision is one of the most awesome effects they've ever added to Minecraft. Now, if you hop out and you toss me the straw, I'll show you how it works, I think.
Okay.
Or at least how I think it works. Now, I didn't get a full level there, but I did see my experience meter jump up.
Okay.
Okay, this is not the only liquid you can drink out of the ground.
Oh my god.
Watch this. Of course, it refills because it's water.
Yeah.
And my night vision is wearing off now.
What if you drink lava?
You get set on fire instantly, therefore I do not recommend it.
Okay.
You can also drink destabilized redstone, which basically is like being struck by lightning. So
okay.
Also not recommended. Yeah, let's set up shop here, or pull up shop.
Oh yeah, you can just use a pickaxe on that.
Yep. So this was a very effective demonstration, I should say, if graphic at parts.
Yeah.
But the main thing is that there's a whole bunch of liquids. The whole reason that the straw is added is because you can't drink out of buckets anymore.
Okay.
Also, if we were to take that bucket of mob essence that I just drank and put it in the nether, it would actually function as water because the nether doesn't recognize it, therefore it wouldn't turn into steam.
Okay.
So basically we could turn everything there into obsidian. We don't want that because that's where our power plant is, but it is an option.
Okay.
Just throwing that out there.
Sure.
If you think that was a little bit strange...
Hey, Anna, how... Like, here's a bucket of some green goo that we generated from killing several of our enemies. And Here's a straw. Enjoy!
Yep. Yeah, I figured that would be your reaction. But I had to be sure. Which is why I asked in the first place.
Oh, my God.
Okay. You will go into a portal to hell and try a dimensional cross-rip book portal thingy, which could, if you screwed it up, could easily land you in a parallel dimension for the rest of your life.
Mm-hmm. See, that I don't have a problem with.
Yeah,
it's drinking green shit from a bucket.
Someone says, why don't you try this new drink and chicken out, basically. I'm not saying that you're not. I'm not saying that's not a valid reaction. I'm just saying that under the circumstances, trying the green liquid might have been safer than going to hell. That's all I'm saying. You probably can't hear the smile on my face.
No.
I can't laugh because it hurts the back of my throat. To do so right.
Sorry. I'll try and settle down.
No, I did that. I've been like this since the instant you basically gave me the "Are you serious?" look, and I didn't know you could do that in Minecraft.
Oh man, I wish we could record your screen.
Well, basically, the idea is that we're gonna need mob essence for the auto spawner loop thing.
Yes,
and we should pick out a spot like this corner over here for our mob essence generator.
Mm-hmm.
I'll just get rid of this rubber tree because we're going to need some more in the bit to make more plastic sheets.
Okay. Do you want to make like a mob spawning room?
We will need to fence it in, yes.
Okay.
And the outside of this thing would work just fine. There is a slight issue in that the... Sorry, my head is a little bit...
It's okay.
Stuffy.
Napra.
So the area for the mob spawner to operate in. It's independent of light level, as far as I know.
Oh, okay.
But it's wider than the grinder, so we're going to have to fence the area off.
Okay.
Otherwise, it's going to try and spawn through the blocks.
Here, let me look that up. I want to know... Tekkit wiki auto spawner.
I just realized my inventory is completely full. I need to empty some of this stuff out.
Okay. How do I want to know what the radius is. Doesn't say. Like, I can't seem to find it. Give me specs!
Are you looking on the Tekkit wiki?
I'm looking on three different wikis now.
This copper warp.
The Mine Factory one does not seem to want to load.
Well, I'm putting the grinder in this thing over here. We'll figure it out later.
Okay.
In all honesty, I don't think I can continue to talk much longer.
Okay.
So, in fact...
Do you want to call it a night?
I may need to get a drink in a couple minutes.
Okay, you could do that.
But I do want to call the recording session, because, the whole reason of talking like this is so we can get the dialogue back and forth, and I'm not going to be able to dialogue very...
No worries.
You remember how it was, like, week before last with the pizza?
Yes.
Imagine that, but about four times more
okay.
so.
Okay. No worries. You don't have to continue to explain why you can't talk. We can call it here.
So, I will be back. In fact, I will probably just empty out my inventory and go AFK.
There's an Enderman on the second floor.
I'm not terribly surprised. But...
Okay.
You know, I just got to... go out and hope that the winter air makes it better and not worse.
No worries. I'm going to stop the recording right now, okay?
Okay. And I'll see you in a minute or so.
Okay, no worries.
And we can continue shenaniganry.
Stop talking and go take care of yourself. Bye.
Yeah, bye.